Hey guys, and welcome to another video. I wanted to make a quick video about this laptop here. So if you've watched my previous video, I talked about how it ended up crashing when I took it to Razer. It turns out that I needed a new motherboard, something that looks like this. And they quoted me a price of $1,400, and I ended up saying no, and I just put it in, literally it was in this drawer for about 2 years. Now recently I was browsing through eBay, because I do get messages and email notifications from them from time to time, because what I did was I ended up posting the saving a search basically, so I get notified for any motherboards that are compatible with this laptop. Now this is the 2019, I think it was the 2019 late, I'll put it somewhere in the screen, this is the 2019 model, late fall or something. And I was curious, so I was getting notifications for the exact same motherboard for around anywhere from $800 to $900, which is still expensive. Now because of the way eBay is set up, you know, if you search for something long enough, you'll start getting recommendations. So what ended up happening is I got a recommendation for this keyboard, and because I browsed through these for so long, I can tell that it's compatible just by the looks of it. Okay, it has a certain way, the layout and everything, I was so familiar with it. So what I ended up doing is that I checked it, and it turns out this was a later model than the one I actually wanted. So if you notice here, if you read here, this one says the Razer Blade 17 Pro motherboard, RZ da 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 da, i7 10th generation something something, RTX 3080. The one I had was actually the i7-98750 or 8755 something, and then the it was the GTX, if I'm not mistaken, GTX 2080 Super. So if you are wondering if the motherboard will fit or not, the answer is absolutely yes. There's no tricky anything basically. I was browsing through Reddit, and you know, I read somewhere that, you know, some of the cables may not fit, or I don't know, the all types of different things, but it was an absolute exact match, an absolute exact match. I'll go even to show you system settings. Even on the system, it says it's updated to, it's basically adopted the new motherboard exactly as you would expect. I'm saying to the point where you can see here, it's basically it updated itself to the newest, there you go, Blade Pro. I'm trying not to show all the information, but you get the point. Blade Pro 17 early 2021. So yeah, the answer is yes, it does work. And I didn't need a repair technician or anything. I did the whole thing myself. I went to iFixit, how to disassemble. I disassembled it. I ordered this thing on, well, basically I ordered first and then I waited for the thing to arrive. It took about a couple of weeks. Once it came through, I disassembled the laptop, and then I put in the new motherboard, and it took about 30 seconds or so, and then it just turned on, and it was exactly as I remember it to be. I mean, even the files, everything, nothing was lost, obviously, because everything is stored on the SSD. The only thing I had to do was that I had to basically reactivate Windows through, I think they call it the digital license or something. So, and when I say I didn't have to pay anything, basically, it's just that because it's a new motherboard, the license is baked into the motherboard, so you just need, there's a certain way to go about it, and it's very simple. So yeah, there you go. There you have it. Can you upgrade your laptop, or can you upgrade your Razer Blade laptop to a newer motherboard? The answer is yes. The only thing is, I would say, is just be careful, because I browsed through this thing for so long. I knew exactly. Basically, what I did was I took pictures of, or I took photos, very high resolution photos of the motherboard of my, before I disassembled it, of my laptop. And then I put it side by side with the one that I intended to buy. And there didn't seem to be any difference whatsoever. The only difference was, I think it was somewhere, I don't think you can see it from here, but it's basically the only thing, I dropped the battery. But the only thing that seemed different was the GPU. The GPU is built in a certain way where you know, it has certain components. That's the only difference. The ports, the connectors, this is, I believe, the screen connector, the camera or the sensors, the, you know, the facial ID, whatever, it fits perfect. Everything is exactly the same. The ports, the screws, everything was perfect. So I took a leap of faith and it worked out. Obviously, because it was an expensive purchase, so you won't find that many people talking about this. I would recommend, however, do your homework. And the only thing that actually pushed me to take this, or to, you know, to try this, was that the seller was offering, I believe it was free shipping and then up to 30 days of return. So I tried it and it works. So I hope you find this helpful. I did this video basically because, you know, during my research, I found very little information on how to upgrade or how to swap your motherboard or how to do any of this stuff. But in the end, it paid off. I hope you like it. If you find the video useful, give it a like, and thank you for watching.